people, welcome to this video. I will explain you here how to use the new Adobe Dreamweaver CC. If you are searching for something in detail, check the index in the video description. What is Dreamweaver CC? It is a software used to create a website project or files related, such as JavaScripts or web codes. You can create a website page using other ways, for example WordPress. However, if you want to create a personalized custom page, this program is the right solution. I will show it without going in detail with the HTML code. Mind that it is better if you know it as well, since it does represent the very basic structure of a website page. Let's start creating a new website. We will see here just how to use the software and the first steps to create a very easy page. We will take this page for example. When you will be more practical, you will make a better page indeed. This is just to learn how to use this software. We will put a banner on top, used to describe the website in short, and fix its name, a navigation bar to browse through the site, a background that covers all, a text description on such background, and, at the bottom, three columns representing descriptions of articles that lead on secondary pages. First thing to keep in mind is the difference between local and remote files or folders. All files and folders in your personal computer are considered local or in local servers. When you will publish a website with all its files, you will put them on a remote server, which is a different server, which is not your computer. To create a new website page, click on HTML in the welcome window. We will see here just this kind, since it is the more complete one than the other types of files. If you want to start with ready templates, go to File and to New. Choose the kind of file from Page Type section and choose the template through the Layout one. On the right you can have a nice preview of what you are going to pick. Fixed means that the length is blocked, and it's represented through a lock. To create websites that need to be adapted, and so with no sizes fixed, you need to go to Fluid Grid Layout. That helps you creating websites adjusted according to which device is watching the page, from mobile to desktop view. Then go to Create. First of all, a page must have a Dreamweaver site, which defines the local and the remote folders that will contain the files of your website. Go to Site and then to New Site. In Site section, give a name to your website. And, below, define the local root folder, which is the main folder that will contain all the files of your website related. You won't need to open this folder manually. Go to Windows section and click on Files if unchecked. Use this Windows section to open all the windows you don't find anymore. This window lets you browse in both local and remote folders, through all the files inside and in your computer as well. Go to Site, Manage Sites to manage your sites created in the future. Let's describe the basic workspace. You have four buttons in the top left corner. The code section shows off the code used. This can be HTML, Java or other kinds of codes. You will have just this section if your file is a code file. The design view lets you work on the page directly without the code. This section can be used only if the file is not a simple code, just like a website page. The split view shows the code and the design at the same time. Live section gives you a preview of how the website looks like. These sections suggest you how a website is composed. A website is defined by an HTML code that rules all, such as sizes, placement, graphic options and links as well. What you see of the website is its code converted in graphic visualization through a browser. Dreamweaver gives you the chance to organize the HTML code in div tags that are parts of the code managed together. These are described by the cascading style sheets, or CSS. Each CSS sets the placement, the size and the graphic aspect of each div tag. To start making them, you need to know how to make your website first. This structure can be seen on the right. The sources are files that are linked to your website, such as the CSS files. The Selectors window lists all your div tags, preceded by a hash. A cascade of two div tags shown means that the right div tag is contained in the left div tag, which is more important. For example, a piece of text on a background. Let's start saving our site. Go to File and then to Save As, or press Ctrl and S. The file must be saved in your local folder set. Its name is important, since it will appear in the address of the website when browsed. Since this is the first page, we can call it index.html. The file will appear in the File section. Let's create the div tags. We can describe the HTML code in groups where parts of codes are managed together. The div tags are groups of code rows usually related to the same object or file. Go to Insert panel and then to Div. Remember this panel if you want to insert other things. First of all, a stable site structure is always composed by a basic div tag that contains all the website in full, and inside such tag all the others. The banner will have its div tag, the text box its one, and so on. In the new window, start creating the basic div tag and give it a name through the ID slot, for example call it container. Once done, you will see the code changed. Dreamweaver lets you create the website without working directly on the code. Each thing created or edited through the software will be reported on the code, so you can create the page without knowing the coding too deep. If you want to edit through the code, you will need to refresh the rendered design on the other side. Just press F5 or go to View and then to Refresh Design View. Then create the other div tags for each part of the website. Go to the code and press Enter to add a new line right below the container tag. This will add the div tags inside the container tag. Then go on with the div command scene. To recognize them in the future, give them a name through the ID slot. Don't use any blank space for the ID. Then you need to define the CSS styles to give a shape and a placement for each div tag. Go to File and then to New. Select CSS and then go to Create. As you can see, the CSS file is a code file only. However, to make it work with the website in progress, you need to attach the CSS file to it. Close the CSS file opened, go to CSS Designer window in your HTML file, in Sources section, and click on the plus you see. Go to Attach existing CSS file and, in the new window, go to Browse to select your CSS just created. There is no relevant difference between import and link, just select import and then go to OK. The CSS attached is shown above. The source code is the main HTML code of the website, but the graphic style is defined by the linked CSS file next to the source code. You can link more CSS files. Let's now project the CSS file inside. Unfortunately, making it needs a lot of time and practice, since you need to know all the commands and how they work. We will see just the main important commands to start up with DWCC. First of all, you can edit your CSS file in two ways. You can work directly on the code, or you can use the Properties section below Selectors. Much easier for beginners. Select the CSS file in Sources. This CSS file will have all its div tags listed in selectors. You can add and delete each selector through the plus and minus in the corner. Mind that this doesn't delete the div tag, but just the properties added through the CSS file. So just select a div tag and start editing it through properties section below. If it's too much small, simply click and drag its edges. The properties section shows all the attributes you can add to your div tag selected. They are divided in different parts. You can scroll the full list below or use the quick icons on top. To see better how these properties work, let's edit a div tag inside a container. Mind to have live view enabled first. This is useful to see the effects of the properties immediately. Changing properties is very easy. You can drag on the numbers to change them, or double-click to type them directly. Click on the measurement unit to change it. When you need to change the color, just click on the rectangle. The color with a dark diagonal means no color, so invisible. The text section is used to manage fully the text of the div tag. This can be added simply typing inside the box in design view. Then use text in properties to change color, font and kind of text or shadow. The borders section is used to set the borders of the div tag box. Normally the box is invisible by default. So simply change the property border style to enable it. You can make it visible, change color and thickness. The layout is used to set width and height and space definition for the box that contains the div tag. This box locates the div tag and its content inside. The border enabled lets you see it directly. Margin sets a blank space that moves the div tag around your site. This is shown through the graphic example. The white area is the content of the div tag. The darker gray one, the property interested, in this case the margin. Click on the center to set the margin on each side separately. Padding adds blank space between the div tag's box edges and the edges of its container, so it moves its text content inside. Use position to move your box and set its position according to the site's edges. The background rules any image or color used inside the div tag box, and you can import images to use as backgrounds for div tags, but mind that these must be saved in your local root folder first, as requested by the software. Remember that a property set for the container tag is applied on the other tags you have, since these are defined inside the container tag in your code. The attributes added through properties section can be found in your CSS file. Once the CSS file is finished, your website will be complete on its design. Meanwhile, use the live view to check your project and save often. Use Edit Undo to delete the latest mistaken action or use Ctrl and Z. Last thing to see is how to put two boxes one beside another. We can simply use the merging property until the two boxes are next to each other. Keep in mind the concept of padding. It can be seen as a way to set the sides of the boxes. Indeed, it sets a safe distance between the box and the text content. This means that if you add a longer text, you may need to edit your padding values and refreshing with F5. Watch out! Well, this is all. I hope this helped you. Check the next videos of this show to know how to create a website with Dreamweaver CC. Thanks for watching.